It's a real honor to have you here. How are you doing right now, Bob?
No, I do okay. I have better day, but life go on. I'm very good. I'm very good today.
We are all a big fan of the work you did yesterday on one of his charities. How do you think that interview went?
Oh, I will say I'm very good. Very good. Shockingly, I think I did okay. It was a lot of pressure, and Dr. Gupta was there. He sort of coached me through it. I think it could have gone better. Being dead for about 46 seconds, okay for me, because I learned a lot from experience. I learned a ton from the experience I have of being dead for a small amount of time. And the Dr. Gupta, very good. He helped, you know.
Do you think Dr. Gupta did okay?
He could have done better, but, you know, we all learn from experience.
What would you say it's like on a day-to-day basis working with a medical professor like Dr. Gupta? Just day-to-day, very general. How would you say it goes?
Probably very different from most people in the medical industry. It is very strenuous to work with someone so high energy. He very high energy. He have a lot of good idea, very experimental. And it's strenuous for me to keep up with him. We both have big personalities, and I think that leads to a bit of contrast, but it works out.
How do you get along with your father-in-law, Juanita the First?
Not very good, not very good.
Well, would you care to go into any further details?
Well, he never really liked me, ever. I think because I hate China, and he America, and I get along with one of the junior very good. But when we in the same room, again, same thing, big personality never go along very good. When big personality get together, a lot of contrast in the room. And it's always been, he racist to me, I saw the racist to him, he called me China, I call him racist. It never really worked out too well, we never really get along. It's always been, you know, him on one side of the room, me on the other side of the room. I think it works out that way, we both know we hate each other.
As you know, Juanita the First is a very well-known individual. He's very high up in the business world and the entertainment industry. Everyone loves him, and everyone, you know, has a great deal of respect for him. How would you say he's really different in real life than if you were, you know, to hear him on the radio? Would you say that's the same personality you see at Thanksgiving dinner, or would you say it's, you know, is it just a polar opposite?
Well, I would say it's more of a character than a polar opposite. He has some similarity between what people know him as and what I know him as. And I would have to say, you know, it's a really similar, he very open with a lot of people. But there is a sense of it is a character because he is not near as blunt in the public eye as in the private life. He very scrutiny. He has a lot of scrutiny for a lot of type of people, and he never really showed that when he do the big fancy shows and the entertainment industry type of thing. And I would say that milieu of him being mean to people is much more apparent in his real life. For example, he's much more, you know, tell you how to do it, this is how you do it, you know. But in the show, he's like more free and open with guests, even though he can be dick sometime, he dick all time of life, as opposed to just the sometime in the public life style that he lead. I would say a lot of time, it's you don't know when you're gonna get with him. If he just leave show, he'd be very nice. If you see him and it been 2 weeks and show, he'd be very mean. And I see him frequently, but it is not as frequent as people make it out to be. I don't think of him as celebrity. I think of him as jerk father-in-law who just treat me like human garbage. Never really more a thing like here, you know. It's like I'm my father-in-law is Juanita First. It's more like, oh yeah, that guy on the radio, I think he's my father-in-law, you know, it's difficult to explain, but you get it when you have celebrity and family. It's very strenuous, and it's complicated to understand, especially since I'm married to the black sheep of the family. No one really get along with Juanita Jr., and so it's very, it's difficult to live like that. Very difficult. to experience all of that hate just a lot of the time. He likes to build on to it. It's just the way he do thing. Nothing personal, just more of how he never really liked me. I never liked him, you know. We get along okay just for the appearance, but in a private, he can be very mean to people. Much more mean than other people would think about him. It's just a personal flaw of his. And I would say that we see each other okay amount. Thanksgiving dinner and, you know, Christmas dinner, you betcha. But, you know, birthday, maybe not all time. Even though we live right across the river, we don't see each other all that time. On occasion, we were.
What about 4th of July?
One time, you know. Anyway, I would say it's nothing too much worry about. It's more of, you know, can I handle the stress that will come with having to deal with him again? Or should I just cure myself? I'm suicidal a lot of time. I'm very suicidal, mainly because he's total anus sheet. He never nice to me. He's giant nipper.
How are your grandkids and kids doing?
They actually okay. They do okay. You know, Mark married his half-sister, Juanita, you know. My grandson married my daughter. And, you know, that's very interesting for me. But it's okay. Job is doing good. He get married in November. Very much so look forward. yes. I look forward to the wedding.
Chances are, 'cause I wear a silly grin, the more